We built tools to stretch our hands, then our thoughts, in dim studios and humming labs. The first promises of automation whispered, freedom from toil. A machine that could count, then compute, then mimic a voice. Each step felt like magic and menace. But behind every invention stood a human silhouette, a questioner, a tinkerer, a tired apprentice. History taught us one thing persistently. Tools changed tasks, not the heart. Workplaces rearranged quietly. Clerks displaced. Creators repurposed. A calculator reduced hours. A program reduced entire processes into lines of logic. At first, we celebrated efficiencies, as if efficiency itself was salvation. But the human, cost, identity, rhythm, pride, arrived, patient and precise. We learned to frame progress as a mirror. What we gain is often what we must re-see. Today, algorithms arrive not as cold machines, but as collaborators whispering suggestions. They parse language, surface patterns, and compress time, giving us drafts of thought. People using these tools move faster, see further, make different choices. The gap is not between human and machine, it is between the human who learns the tool and the human who does not. Power, then, is a practical habit to learn, adapt, and wield with judgment. Speed without reflection breeds brittle choices. Efficiency without ethics breeds hollow outcomes. We face choices about which tasks to automate and which to protect as human work. When a resume is parsed by a line of code, whose story gets a chance to be read? When a diagnosis is suggested by probability, who holds the responsibility for the single patient? These are not technical bugs. They are moral contours we must map. Data produces answers. Humans ask the questions that matter. Creativity, context, and moral courage remain stubbornly human terrains. The person who pairs curiosity with tools, crafts, opportunities that the tool alone cannot. Skill becomes less about memorizing facts and more about learning how to ask, test, and decide. This is the hinge between being replaceable and becoming indispensable. Meet a teacher who used AI to personalize lessons and found attention returning to students once lost. Meet a factory operator who learned to supervise algorithms and kept the plant open, not idle. Meet a writer who taught a model to draft, then wrote sentences that only a human could feel. These small revolutions are practical and precise. They are not magic, but disciplined imagination. They show that adaptation is a craft made of patience, practice, and occasional stubbornness. Mastery asks for routines, how you train, how you critique, and how you fail forward. Learning to use AI is not a single course, it's iterative apprenticeship with feedback loops. The best practitioners design constraints for the tool, so it amplifies human judgment, not erodes it. We must teach not only how to press buttons, but how to interpret outputs and decide what to keep. A future of competence will be measured by synthesis joining machine scale with human sense. Models will predict markets, moods, and medical markers. They will anticipate needs before words arrive. This intimacy is double-edged. It can nurture or it can nudge in unseen directions. Our task is to decide where anticipation becomes appropriation and to build breaks where needed. Design choices will encode values transparency, contestability, dignity, or they will encode convenience. The future will reflect the ethics we choose today, often in recipes hidden inside code. Responsibility is not a static title. It is an active loop of accountability, audit, and repair. When errors happen, the story must trace from output back through intent to oversight. Communities must have means to contest decisions that affect livelihoods, health, and voice. Regulation without literacy is brittle. Literacy without rules is powerless. We need institutions that teach, tools that reveal, and cultures that refuse convenient amnesia. Here is the honest horizon. AI expands possibility, but it does not ennoble purpose. We choose whether tools deepen human flourishing or consolidate advantage for the few. The person using AI with care becomes a multiplier of empathy, craft, and conscience. If we train curiosity, ethics, and resilience alongside algorithms, we create a future of shared agency. That future asks not what will replace us, but what we will become when partnered with our own inventions. The machines we built are not opponents, but amplifiers of human choice. Each algorithm is a mirror, reflecting what we feed into it, revealing patterns we often overlook. Opportunities emerge in the quiet spaces where human intuition meets computational power. Yet, every tool carries a test. Will it deepen empathy or hollow ambition? The future is not dictated by circuits, but by the attention and values we bring to them. History teaches patience, not shortcuts. Those who master tools without understanding their limits risk illusion of control. Human insight transforms raw data into wisdom. Machine efficiency cannot replace discernment. Every interaction with technology is a lesson in responsibility, demanding reflection as much as action. In classrooms, factories, and studios, the same principle echoes. Curiosity paired with diligence creates impact. It is not enough to adapt. One must evolve, integrating imagination with precision. Innovation is a dialogue between human ambition and machine precision. Those who listen carefully learn the language of probability, pattern, and prediction. They shape AI to enhance human values, creativity, ethics, empathy, instead of eroding them. Even small interventions, like refining a recommendation or prioritizing fairness, ripple across systems. The quiet victories of thoughtful users often surpass the loud triumphs of raw computation. Mistakes will happen, but reflection ensures growth. Each failed attempt teaches boundaries, ethics, and foresight. AI amplifies both our brilliance and our oversight. Responsibility is the counterbalance. The future favors those who practice vigilance alongside curiosity. A single person, aware of these forces, can shape outcomes far beyond their apparent reach. We are architects of an evolving partnership, where intelligence is shared, not surrendered. We stand at a hinge, not of surrender, but of authorship. The machines extend our reach. How far we go will be written by the habits we form, the questions we keep, and the compassion we refuse to outsource. What if the real competition isn't between human and machine, but between those who learn to steward technology and those who let it steer them? If this story moved you, lend it your attention, like, share, and subscribe to join the conversation about who we will become.